Hello and welcome. I'm here in Beamng Drive. This is version 0.27. And I want to show you how I put vehicles and objects into the game. I had been trying the tutorials I had seen online to do this, and they look very well put together, but they're not working for me. I don't know if it's the version number or whatnot, but they didn't work. So this does work, and I'm going to show you how to do it. If you notice in the background here, I have a van parked over there. I'm just going to tab around quickly here to show you some of the assets I put into my game. It's Prefabs. Here we go. Back to the van, back there, back here. These guys, if you want these dummies, they've recently been put back on. Let me pop in here to show you which one it is, so I don't say it wrong. It's a universal dummy /forward/stuntman. I almost look like Versus in the middle. It's that one. I also have, these are my only two mods installed. I also have the crash hard dummies, which are very nice. But I have them deactivated the moment since I got this new one, and I just want to, I'm still checking that out as well. But so far, it's really worth it. It's a lot nice, a lot nicer, a lot more options available for them. But let's get back out of here and continue here. These are the prefabs, though. So the car, the two dummies, and the truck is one prefab all together. But today, for tutorial purposes, I'm going to show you basic on how to do this. So let me respawn back into my level. I've reset my spawn point to a different location as to show you this tutorial. So be right back. So here we are. I'm spawned back in to the dockyard area of West Coast. And you can see my assets still popped in the background. So what we want to do now is I'm just going to pull my truck up a little bit here. Let me get the sound going back on this side. Pull it up here a little bit. Stop it right here. Okay, and now we're going to spawn in the vehicle that I want to make as a prefab. And what I want to do is I want to put a police car in this parking lot, just a parked police car, that every time I come into West Coast Dockyards area, that police car will always be here in this parking lot until I remove it or whatnot. But anyway, so let's spawn in a police car. I think I've already decided on which one I'm going to use just for this tutorial, and I'll show you couple of things I want to do before I make it a prefab. I'll use this one. I'm going to use the black and white one. Police package. That one there. I'm going to spawn it as a new vehicle. Alright. I'm not really going to do anything with it yet. Other than let's go ahead and let's do our modifications I want to do. Which I'm going to put a dummy in there. So we'll go up here to vehicle configuration. Now this new dummy package has, you do it under the license plate design. I'm not really going over the dummies themselves. I like to put them in my cars. And there's a lot to them as well. Okay, so we have the dummy in. And the next thing I want to do, and I'll tell you why I do this, is the I'm going to put the fuel volume to the zero and apply that. Okay, so we got that done. And it's best to do all this. You can go back after you've done the prefab and do this, but it's just easier on the beginning to have it already done. And the reason I put the car in with no fuel is in case I want to play this version, go AI chase me, and I don't want all my prefab vehicles chasing me around the map if I'm just selecting a scenario where I want one vehicle to chase me or whatever. If you do want these vehicles to join in, or you want to drive them around, you just go to the tuning and put the fuel back in. So anyway, so we got that. There we go. So we got our car set up like we want. Now what we need to do is make it into a prefab. So to do that, we're going to hit the go into the mission editor, F11, or world editor, I'm sorry. Right over here, you see the player and the spawn vehicles would be the clone 14. And the reason it's clone 14 is because of all the other prefabs. I'm going to hide my vehicle for now. Okay, and you can see the spawn point, and that's how I put it here. If you didn't know, you can always come into Mission Editor. You hide your vehicle, you can see your spawn point. You can move it wherever you want on the map. We're going to go back here to our police vehicle. And similar to the tutorials I've seen before, you're going to right-click this clone vehicle here, clone number 14. And we are going to put it into a new group. What you'll see the group come up is Sim Group. And our clone. We're going to right click it one more time. And we're going to pack into Prefab. And all your prefabs come up. You can see some I've made before. I like to use the caps lock just to spot mine easily. We need to name it, so we come down here to file name, and I'm just going to call it police, and we're going to save that. And now we have the prefab as police, and you'll see the icon changed over here to a prefab. Now you can't edit this vehicle or anything while it's in packed into a prefab, but you can always unpack it, edit it, and repack it. So we have our vehicles done. So now what we want to do, it's there. I'm going to put my my vehicle back. First, I want to save this. Important to save. Always save. I'm clicking the save icon. You can also hit Control S or File Save. You hit this. Just make sure you see that the level's saved right up here. The level's saved. Okay. I'm going to unhide my vehicle. Now we've made our prefab. So we're going to exit the editor. And now we're going to reload the level. So let's go up here, main menu, free roam, West Coast USA, and dockyards, and spawn. Okay, we're back, and you can see all our previous prefabs in the background, but we don't see the new one we just made, because that's because you have to, it will have to be loaded the first time. So if we go to our, I'm just going to pull my vehicle up again, just a little bit here. So we go to the mission editor again. A world editor. I don't know why I keep calling mission editor. It's from another game, I think. I use a mission editor in it. I'm gonna go ahead and hide my vehicle one more time. Now, if you notice here on the left above my vehicle, spawn vehicles, it's just showing me only. There's all my other ones. My semi and trailer, work van, all of them are showing. The police one is not showing. So we need to make it show, and to do that, the first thing before you do anything is go ahead and hit J to pause the physics, because when this vehicle spawned, it may not necessarily spawn where you want it to. That meaning it could be down below the surface of the pavement, or just on a different part of the map altogether. But you don't want it just falling for eternity or not able to find your vehicle. So what we do, we pause it with the J key, J for Jello, Juliet. We're going to go up here to window now, and go to our asset browser at the very top. You click on that. Prefabs are 38 prefabs. You're just going to scroll down through till you see your prefab that you just made, the police one. I'm going to right click on this and I'm going to spawn prefab at camera. So boom, there we go. There it is. Now this time it did well. It spawned right in front of me. Okay. But it's not in the correct positions. But now we can move it and put it around where we want. So if you notice though, you click on it. There we go. It's got a handle now. And let's go over here. I'm just gonna move around with the A, S, D, and W keys. My mouse. And I want to position this vehicle. Slider forward a bit. Oop, that's the wrong key. Wrong slider there. That looks good. Be back up a little bit because it'll look good one way and you move to a different location and it doesn't look right. So it looks like it's a little too far left. And it's come around the side. It looks like to me it's going to come forward a little bit. As a matter of fact, I'll tell you what I want to do. I want it facing the other way. So the one key, or the number two key on your keyboard, will change it to the rotation tool. And the one key will change it back. But we want to rotate it. I have my snapping is set at 5, so it shouldn't go too far when we snap or rotate. So we're going to rotate it to about look straight, and then we're going to go back, hit our one key, move the car, and let's go around and look at it again. Yeah, the way it was when it spawned into the game there, with it being kind of below the pavement, I don't know, it might have just fell straight through. So what we want to do now is make sure there's tires in the pavement, go up a little bit. It looks good right there. I'm going to hit the J key now. There she is. Okay, now she's a prefab in the game. All right, and what I want to do next. Next, I want to, well, first of all, I want to put my vehicle back. You see it. Next major thing to do is save it. Make sure we save it. Level saved. I'm going to hit F11 to get out of the editor. Go back to the police car here. And now, when we reload the game, which I'm going to do now, this police car should always be there and drivable. But we put no fuel in it, so it can't chase me unless I put fuel in it. And let's reload it and see if it's there this time. West Coast, Dockyard, Spawn. Okay, we're back here, and now you see the prefab is there. And it's going to be there every time. I quit my game, come back, this car is parked here. Unless I remove it. Maybe you can move it. If you need to edit the car, just remember you have to unpack the vehicle. And I want to show you one little quick tip on that because this is important. So we're going to hit F11 for the mission editor. Our world editor. There I go again. The world editor. There we go. All right. So now you see the police vehicle here. So if I want to do any editing or anything, I would to the vehicle itself, I would unpack it. If I want to get rid of the vehicle, just totally get rid of it, you can right click, delete the objects, and it's gone. I'm not going to do that because I've made it. I want to keep it for now. But it would be gone. It wouldn't show up over here or anything. But it still would show up even after you deleted it there. It would still show up here under the asset browser. It would still show up under the police on the asset browser. So what you do, and this is not removable from here. Basically, you can't just right click it and remove it. But it can show it in the Explorer. So if you show it in Explorer, delete this prefab, and then it is totally gone. So that's the way to get rid of it and not clutter up your folders. And one more thing I wanted to point out is, like, when you're doing a, I did this asset, this prefab, with the car, the two dummies, and the other vehicle here, all is one prefab. So when you do a prefab like that, it's the same as the police car, other than, say, these were your objects you put in before you made them into a group. You would just click it, shift, click all the ones that's going to be in there, right click, put in a new group, and then pack into a prefab. All right, so I hope this has been helpful to everyone. It's been helpful to me since I figured out how to do it, because I was really frustrated with trying to do this. It's something I wanted to do. But anyway, you guys have a great day, and thanks for watching. One more thing I want to throw in there quickly before I'm totally gone is, if you do a lot of editing there, you might notice when you go back into your game, you may some things, the textures get a little jittery or whatnot. All you need to do is come in here, go to your game launch, go to support tools, click the top one, clear cache. It'll take a few minutes, but it'll reset everything, and you won't lose any of your mods or anything like that. I don't do the deep clean or nothing, just this top one. You do that and then let the game reload, and it should be fine. Just wanted to throw that in there. Thanks again, once again, for watching. We'll see you around.